SS Cyberwolf has found herself to become one of the most successful creators on YouTube, so successful that this year alone she has gained over 700 million views and has gained over 32 million subscribers, which is absolutely impressive. If you don't know her, SS Cyberwolf is a very popular reaction channel with the least amount of talent, but her audience absolutely loves her and adores her so much and supports her a lot of the time. And on the outside, SS Cyberwolf just looks like a pretty girl who makes innocent reaction videos on the internet for her young audience. And that is the case on the outside, as she gets millions of views, has a good like to dislike ratio, and has very supportive comments on her videos. However, the thing is, people don't truly know the real SS Cyberwolf. People don't truly know her past and all the drama she got herself into on her time on the internet, and people don't know her true colors. They just know SS Cyberwolf to be that very happy girl that loves making videos for them. Countless channels have exposed SS Cyberwolf for her lies, her slandering creators, and manipulating other people. As you're seeing by this title, this is a content nuke video where basically we're gonna be going over all of SS Cyberwolf's baddie side. Okay, so if you're new, subscribe, drop a like, and let's get into the video.
What's up, guys? Today I am here with Bay Sensor, and we are doing a Would You Rather video.
Hey,
folks, I'm Job is literally sitting in front of a camera for like an hour, a couple hours a day, playing with yourself.
It's not even me. Why is this hoe in the thumbnail?
In 2017, SS Cyberwolf and FaZe Sensor were supposedly friends at this time, as they both made a video together. Prior to this, SS Cyberwolf and the YouTuber FaZe Banks had got into some drama. So in 2017 on Twitter, FaZe Banks would tweet out to FaZe Sensor, "Yo, Doug, my guy, FaZe Sensor, how many times did Cyberwolf hit you up for that FaZe dick?" while she had a boyfriend. Basically saying how FaZe Sensor got hit up by Cyberwolf, while Cyberwolf was already in a relationship with her boyfriend Sausage at the time. And Cyberwolf was also flirting with FaZe Sensor in some of other Banks' tweets. When Banks had made these claims about Cyberwolf, this then caused Cyberwolf to retaliate back, with her saying that Sensor hit her up first and was flirting with her and trying to hook up with her, and also calling the messages of SS Cyberwolf trying to hook up with FaZe Sensor fake. FaZe Sensor would then drop a video about the situation on the 25th of June 2017, proving SS Cyberwolf wrong and showing all the messages of her trying to hook up with him, while he had his girlfriend in the video.
So I'm just gonna say on record here, guys, I never had sex with Cyberwolf, I never kissed Cyberwolf, but for her to say that she never flirted with any other men or tried to get with anybody from FaZe is a complete bullshit lie. I have text that shows that she tried to get with me. So when she messaged me yesterday and told me to stand up for her, I told her I wasn't gonna get involved. I didn't wanna sit here and expose her and show these text messages she sent me 2 years ago, because I just think that's so petty. But when you're gonna sit there and messages to me and you're gonna lie and say that you never texted me, and then you're gonna talk smack about my girlfriend, then you're gonna question my integrity, I'm mad! She texted me saying, "Hi, you're cute." She was in a relationship. The next text she sent me was, "Would talk to you more if I wasn't in an abusive relationship I can't get out of." Never secrets, flirted, slept with any guy but my man. Wait, do people really think I tried getting with anyone from FaZe? Other way around, kids.
She's a liar, guys.
Last time I checked, when you text somebody saying, "Hi, you're cute," that tells me that's the most obvious way of flirting.
Even with FaZe Sensor backing up these claims about Cyberwolf, she still had claimed that FaZe Sensor was lying and calling the entire thing bullshit. So what FaZe Sensor did next is he went to Verizon and got an entire Verizon employee to prove that the text messages of Cyberwolf saying all that were real and weren't edited.
"Hi, you're cute.
He's here.
Would talk to you more if I wasn't in an abusive relationship I can't get out of." Alright, that's everything we need, guys. I don't really know how else I could be faking this in any way at all. These are all from my phone in the back. There's no way that I could change any of this. There's nothing I can do. As you can see, we're here at Verizon. So to be accused of faking a conversation to me is just absolutely ridiculous.
Even after FaZe Sensor went all the way to Verizon to prove everyone that they were real, SS Cyberwolf still didn't want to believe it and tweeted out, "Spoke to a lawyer. It could take months to get the real text messages, as Verizon requires a court order to get actual text logs. However, it would be revealed that the text messages were iMessages and backed up to the iCloud, so therefore they couldn't be edited and were 100% real and backed up." When all this came out about Cyberwolf, she began to start receiving a bunch of backlash. because, well, she got caught lying. As Face Sensor had very, very hard proof that Sniper Wolf was flirting with him while she had a boyfriend, and also saying that she was in an abusive relationship, while trying to lie her entire way out the situation by calling what she said fake. About a month later, Ezra Sniper Wolf's boyfriend, Sajita, got really mad about this entire situation, and he got so mad that he ended up threatening to sue Face Sensor over text. As Sajita told Sensor, they got in contact with a lawyer and was threatening to sue if he didn't take down the videos or admit that the texts were fake, even though they weren't fake.
So the options I was given was to work with Sniper Wolf's attorney and issue an apology and claim that the texts are fake. And that's definitely never gonna happen because those texts are real and she knows it. Option number two is that they sue me. And what they're gonna sue me for, I have no idea. I would love to see that happen. I truly believe that these text messages are just some sort of a decoy. They're trying to make me, I don't know what they're trying to do. They're trying to make me feel that I was wrong about what truly happened. It doesn't make sense. It's so petty. It's so stupid. Sniper Wolf, you don't want to go through all this trouble. I'm telling you right now, I'm not the person you want to mess with. You really need to come out. You need to talk to Sausage behind closed doors. You need to clear the air with him and get all this off of your chest because you got a lot of lies you've been covering up. And it's time to come out, tell him the truth, work something out with him, and then issue a public apology to me. I can't believe you asked me to apologize to you.
Obviously, if they were to actually sue Sensor, SS Sniperwolf and Sajita would most likely not win the lawsuit. As Sensor had more than enough proof and they literally went to Verizon to prove that they were real, and even had the messages backed up to the iCloud. It pretty much showed that Sniperwolf was trying to save her own ass. As because even though there's literal hard proof, she's still trying to dismiss this entire situation and get her to boyfriend and resolve the problem for her. Even Face Sensor would end up explaining why Sniperwolf keeps calling the text messages fake.
So why do you think Sniperwolf is saying the texts are fake in the first place?
She's saying that it's so obvious why she's saying that the texts are fake. She's saying the texts are fake because she admitted, if she says that these texts are real, then she's going to be admitting that her boyfriend
is. She's going to be in a lot of shit with her boyfriend. Yeah, definitely.
But I think he knows that the texts are real. I think he's just trying to cover it up too because he doesn't want to have to go through another PR disaster where people are saying that he's abusing her. Which people are already saying as it is already.
However, this isn't all the controversy as the Sniper Wolf's gotten himself into, because there's kind of a lot to go over in this video. This one's kind of ironic. Throughout Sniper Wolf's channel, she has always preaches about how you can be beautiful in your own way, and saying how she and so many other girls have very low self-esteem. This is notable by her video called Girl Won't Leave Her House Cause She Thinks She's Ugly, where Sniper Wolf reacts to a Dr. Phil video of a girl who thinks she's ugly and won't leave her house. And if she does leave her house, she has to drown her face in makeup. And in the beginning of the video, SS Sniper Wolf goes on to say this.
Hey guys, so I came across this girl on Dr. Phil. She thinks she is the ugliest, most hideous creature on this planet, and no matter what she does, she just thinks she's ugly. I feel like this video is very important, especially if any of you guys struggle with self-esteem issues. I used to have really bad self-esteem issues. Every single day, I get so many comments that say, you're ugly, you're fat, you're getting fat. There's people that completely rip apart how I look. When you want to improve anything in your life, you can't focus on other people. You can't focus on what other people have. It's gotta be just yourself. Just stop comparing yourself to other people. You are your own person. You are special. You are beautiful in your own way. And everybody has something beautiful about them. You will be so much happier when you stop comparing yourself to other people and just focus on yourself.
Now, I'm not gonna play the Dr. Phil video because, you know, not checking my video blocked. But in this video, Sniperwolf talks about how she and so many other girls have suffered from low self-esteem. Because I'm sure, as we all know, back during the COD days, as a Sniperwolf, definitely should have had low self-esteem at that time. However, this statement by SS Sniperwolf would literally go out the window.
There's people that completely rip apart how I look.
That's just so horrible. That Sniperwolf, poor Sniperwolf. Suffered such abuse. Sniperwolf, what an ugly attention whore. LMFAO, giving gamers a bad name. You are the ugliest and most desperate bitches I've ever seen. At least I actually uploaded a livestream video while you're here sucking on controllers. Go check my videos, dumb cow. Just because you're fat ugly doesn't mean you have to be a jealous horse. You're ugly and chubby though. The girl Sniperwolf was talking to replies, I'm beautiful and 125 pounds. I'm underweight, you insensitive and egotistical loser.
Every single day, I get so many comments that say, you're ugly, you're fat, you're getting fat. There's people that completely rip apart how I look.
125 pounds is fat, you dumb pig!
Obviously, SS Sniperwolf being very, very hypocritical. These tweets of SS Sniperwolf making fun of fat and ugly girls are most likely very old tweets that have resurfaced. And it clearly shows SS Sniperwolf just being a piece of shit and flat out going off on these girls for no reason. Well, one reason. jealousy. She'd even also try to call out Yanny Garcia by saying how her ass is fake and hers is real. Yet this was the same person that was saying shit like,
"Girls fucking hate being compared to other girls, but I think she's really pretty. And it's so stupid comparing yourself to other people, like in terms of anything, whether it's looks, success, you're your own person."
When plus, as a Snipe Wolf, you're literally the one that got plastic surgery on your lips and fucking nose to make yourself not ugly anymore. And it worked, cause now she has all these simps after her. And it's funny, cause Essence Nightwolf is pretty much the role model for these young audience. She preaches about low self-esteem when she literally talks down on other women on the internet to make them feel like shit. She was also saying how Jen Seltzer was fake and not natural, and called somebody dumb cause they were just saying how Jen Seltzer was natural. And Nightwolf got all mad about that statement, and she began saying how Jen Seltzer got her nose done at 16, when you're also the person who isn't natural at all. She's also made tweets like, "Sorry, I didn't spend tens of thousands of dollars on plastic surgery to look good. Just a couple hundred dollars on your lips." Basically, she was trying to say how she didn't spend any money in plastic surgery to look good. Just shut the fuck up. It's been revealed that you got plastic surgery on your lips and nose. You're not slick. Now, I'm not shitting on people who have gotten plastic surgery, but when you go out saying how it's wrong to make fun of others and call people fat and ugly who aren't natural, which is wrong, and you act like this, then you're just a hypocritical piece of shit. SS Sniperwolf is jealous and literally compares herself to other women on the internet and talk shit to them to make herself feel better, and that's absolutely terrible. And that's literally what Sniperwolf preaches about to her fans not to do. And it's even more worse because Sniperwolf's kid audience don't even know that their favorite role model is like this. And it's more than likely that she's been talking shit to women like this for a very, very long time. But they're only gonna find out as time goes on. So we talked a little about Sniperwolf herself, but we haven't even touched her content. Now, I usually don't like talking shit about people's videos, but oh my god, her videos are absolutely AIDS. Throughout SS Sniperwolf's channel, she recycles and recycles and recycles and recycles the same goddamn videos over and over and over. And she's been doing this for years. That fucking 2016 water bottle flip challenge race in her thumbnails. Watching one of SS Sniperwolf's videos is like watching one of my videos. She tells some of the most unfunny jokes and actually laughs with them because she actually thinks that they're funny, and has some of the most dog shit reactions.
Look.
Get away from me!
Oh, y'all better get this lady!
I don't even know how she grew her empire to 32 million subscribers with the same dog shit videos and reactions. She barely has even sort of comedy in her videos. While reacting to the video in her videos, she literally just commentates over the video we're watching.
"See this? This is Albert. Everything in this video gonna be made for Albert. They working at an ice cream place and they mix together the tiniest little scoop of ice cream, put in the sprinkles, and then a cup of— So this guy has a bag that's burnt. Like, the leather is burnt. So he took it out and he's gonna fix it. But he has candy. It's literally candy. It's candy and some special juice, powder, medicine. I don't know what the hell it is. So basically, he mixes all of the candy together, puts it in this mold."
Like, yeah, we don't really need you to reiterate what's the video about. We're watching the same thing you're watching too. And just throughout Sniperwolf's channel, it's literally just the same reaction videos. Yet they still pull millions of views. And I wouldn't even be surprised if it was true that she fakes her reactions, cause her reactions don't even sound genuine. She tells shitty jokes and has a very, very forced laugh in her reaction videos. SS Sniperwolf also has a history on her channel for calling out other women and making fun of girls on the internet who touch up their photos on social media to make themselves look better. Basically, photoshopping one of their body parts to make it look better.
"Yeah, we got this girl. She already doing the pose. Break your back to make it look like you got an ass pose unless you got lordosis. I got lordosis, so like, when I'm standing straight, my back automatically curves like this. So you can't make fun of me."
However, SS Sniperwolf would literally be called out and exposed for photoshopping her photos as well. Basically, the YouTuber Nerd City had made a video calling out SS Sniperwolf because she photoshops pretty much all of her photos on social media.
"Evan or Leah or both are beautifying her content. For some reason, she denies that they do, and they really aren't that good at it.
I don't photoshop any of my pics. I don't have time for that shit. You think I got time to take a selfie, put it on my computer, Photoshop that, send it back to my phone, post it on Instagram? Hell no!"
While on a recent vacation, SS Sausage Wolf posted a couple photos that I think are just egregious. For whatever reason, just look at these absolute disasters. The few people that I've shown these two photos to, the first thing they say is, why does she look like a cartoon? Let's tackle this doc photo first. So the major error in this photo is that it looks like someone has clone stamped an overspray onto the wood, onto this dock here. It looks like someone has accidentally erased where the backside of her knee and thigh make contact with the wood. The leg and the dock have basically become one thing.
I can't imagine somebody would do this and think it looks legit and actually post it on social media and people believe it.
This shows yet again SS Nightwolf being very hypocritical, as she's literally calling out people who touch up their photos and Photoshop them when she literally does the same thing. You can go watch Nerd City's video about it, where he basically just absolutely annihilates SS Nightwolf and calls her out for everything. In 2017, a porn video on Pornhub had gone viral, as because in the video, a porn star had looked identical to SS Sniperwolf, and in the video, she was doing some rather naughty stuff. Not that I would know, of course. And of course, this caused a whole bunch of people asking SS Sniperwolf if she does porn, and making a whole bunch of assumptions of her, and people DMing her about it. So SS Sniperwolf would make a video addressing the entire situation about this porn star looking like her. And very quickly, SS Sniperwolf began accusing the porn star for using her name for money and clout.
Here's a picture of her. I will admit, we do look alike. People started finding her videos and thought it was me. I know this is getting her videos more views and she's making more money off of it because people think it's me and people are watching her videos. So I think she's just playing it off as she is SS Sniperwolf impersonator because she's getting money.
But then later in the video, Sniperwolf would then say people are re-uploading the video of this porn star titled SS Sniperwolf, which is why this porn star is getting very popular.
I mean, she can do whatever she wants. She's not advertising it as SS Sniperwolf porn, but people are re-uploading her videos, titling it as a Sniperwolf porno. This is why I contacted Pornhub, because it is not me in these videos and people are thinking it's me and people are spreading it around. Oh, she's a porn star.
So which one is it? Is it her using you for money or is it people re-uploading her video? And throughout the video, SS Sniperwolf, like usual, brings up the point how the porn star's boobs are fake and hers are real. And rightfully so, the porn star ended up seeing this video and got really mad at Sniperwolf and threatened to sue her. So SS Sniperwolf would then drop another video on this situation, and in her video, SS Sniperwolf would say how she didn't slander the porn star when you did. You literally said how the porn star was using your name for views and money. And of course, you bring up that part for literally no reason. And in this video, SS Sniperwolf began talking shit about this porn star.
Her job is going on Chatterbait and fapping. I mean, that's probably you guys' dream job right there. Just sitting at home, fapping in front of a cam, getting loads of money. She does this thing for the biggest donator, which is the loneliest cuck on the planet. The biggest donator gets to be her e-husband. Kind of pathetic. Her job is literally sitting in front of a camera for like an hour, couple hours a day, playing with yourself. That is literally their job. Seriously.
Firstly, you said you wouldn't talk shit about this porn star in your first video. Now you're dissing her job when she literally did nothing to you until you started talking shit and accusing her in the first place. Secondly, you make recycled shitty reaction videos for your young fans that blindly defend you all the time. Plus, she gets mad about this porn star suing her when you're also the same person that tried to get your boyfriend to sue Face Censor just to save your own ass because you knew you were in the wrong. And this was also in the same year, 2017 as well. Sniperwolf, as usual, just being a dumb hoe. How she could have handled the situation and just say it's not her and moved on with her life. Instead, she had to diss her and accuse this girl for no reason and then got mad when she reacts back. So if you guys already know, SS Sniperwolf's favorite word to use is ho. Funny enough, because I already called her ho in this video. Back during the COD days, so before Sniperwolf, she used to go by Sexy Sexy Sniperwolf, and she would always go around calling girls hoes and stuff. There is a video of her talking shit about Alyssa Violent while playing Call of Duty.
Yo, it's Alyssa, like, yeah. If you're not, like, he's boosting her, like, on YouTube. Like, just putting her in everything. I know, he better, no, but she's, yeah. I think she's dating her, his friend. Yeah, her roommate. Huh? She's just like, I'ma just fuck everybody to get a free room.
Oh my god.
This is why I hate girls. Everyone a hoe.
Wow, everybody a hoe? Well, some of Sniperwolf's news would end up getting leaked. And in a now deleted video, Sniperwolf would end up saying that the girl in the picture wasn't her. And she would even call the girl in the picture a hoe.
Again, it's not even me. Why is this hoe in the thumbnail when it's not even me.
However, there'd be multiple pictures of Sniper Wolf with the same phone case and a picture of her wearing the same shoes with the one in the nudes. And Sniper Wolf would even have the same necklace as the girl in the nude pictures. Why is everything so similar? Huh? Because it is Sniper Wolf in the nude pictures. Don't know why she couldn't have just admitted that. It's not even like people are gonna get mad at her. All these simps want to see ass of Sniper Wolf in nudes. So Sniper Wolf likes to call girls hoes when she just called herself one. And it's been confirmed. And I also don't know why she couldn't just admit the fact that it was her in the nudes, since back during the sexy, sexy Sniper Wolf days, you acted like a hoe all the time. So yeah, you're just a hoe like you claim all these girls are, even though they're not. All these girls that Sniper Wolf comes at are literally not bothering her or anyone. They're just living their life, and Miss Perfect wants to talk shit about them for no reason to make herself feel better. Pretty pathetic if you ask me. So probably the most recent controversy Sniper Wolf was in. Basically, in late December of 2021, there was a dying kid that was featured on the No Jumper podcast. Okay, that sounds pretty fucked. There was a kid with cancer that was featured on the No Jumper podcast, and one of the kid's biggest wishes was to talk to SS Sniper Wolf. This was through a video called Making a 10-Year-Old's Final Wish Come True, where in the video, people surprised Kiera, which is the kid's name, with a bunch of stuff and even money. But the 10-year-old wanted to talk to SS Sniper Wolf, as it was her biggest wish before she passed away. So Adam22 would end up telling the kid that he was gonna make it happen. So Adam22 would end up hitting up Keemstar for ways to get in contact with SS Sniper Wolf, and as Adam22 and Keemstar were chatting, Keemstar kept warning Adam22 how much of a piece of shit SS Sniper Wolf really was.
So after this, Adam22 is in a group chat with a bunch of big YouTubers, and he's asking all of us how to get in contact with Sniper Wolf. And I warn Adam22, I'm like, Sniper Wolf is a piece of poo.
But you know, it's the 10-year-old's dream. Not really our place to talk. So Adam22 ended up getting in contact with Sniper Wolf, and Sniper Wolf was able to get in contact with the mother of the sick kid, and Sniper Wolf ended up matching the mother first, asking her wanting to talk to the kid. And honestly, the mother was very excited that she was able to mesh with Sniper Wolf, and they plan to do a video chat with Sniper Wolf tomorrow. Then the same day, the mom had said, perfect, just let us know. Also, let us know if today works. If not, tomorrow's good, but maybe we can set up a specific time. Then Sniper Wolf go on to say, hello, I can in like 2 hours if that works. That is 11 p.m. on our side, we live in Massachusetts. Kiera will most likely not be awake. The Sniper Wolf says, okay, hopefully tomorrow. Does any time during the day work? Yes. Now, the thing that gets me and a lot of the other people is Sniper Wolf could have just talked to this kid, as the kid doesn't have a lot of time to wait. The next thing that happened is when the mom got in contact with Sniper Wolf, the mom ended up posting the DMs on social media of her talking to Sniper Wolf, and guess what Sniper Wolf said next? Hi, please don't post messages. I usually don't do this, and I don't want other people to spam me to video message. Thanks. Okay, I'm sorry, I deleted it. I didn't know. I'm sorry. Bro, it takes like 5 to 10 minutes to video message this girl. What are you doing that is taking all day to do this? You have all the time in the world to go on social media and see these messages and respond back to the mom. Next, Sniper Wolf says, hey, I didn't have time today. I'll let you know tomorrow. Merry Christmas. Then the mom says, hey, Kiera's awake. I don't know if you're around. And Sniper Wolf responds with, hey, sorry, I won't be home for another 2 hours. Might be too late. We can keep trying, but my days are usually very busy. Then up to this point, Sniper Wolf has prolonged the entire situation for days and days. And I remember going on Sniper Wolf's Instagram story during this whole time, and she was literally eating cake. And up to this point, the mom is pretty much fed up with Sniper Wolf. Rightfully so, because her daughter literally has days to live. And then Sniper Wolf said, no need to be rude, I said I would do it. It's Christmas and my family is visiting from out of town. We're good, and then the mom just blocks her. So when all this came out, Keemstar would then make a Twitter video calling out Sniper Wolf a piece of shit, how disgusting she is. Of course, when Sniper Wolf saw this, she would respond by saying, I told her multiple times I would love to video chat her daughter, but we couldn't find a time that worked since my family is visiting and I got sick, so I haven't had time. But the thing is, it's not like you're gonna be visiting Kiera in person. You make videos every single day, so you can't be coming up with all these excuses when this one time someone, and especially someone who's about to die and is a fan of you, wants to video message with you. And after Sniper Wolf received all this backlash, she would go on and make this paragraph state, and she would say that she didn't want to give the kid 5 minutes and how she didn't ghost the kid. However, even if you wanted to give her more time than just 5-10 minutes, you could have easily done that, because like I said, SS Sniper Wolf posts YouTube videos every single day, and you have all the time to browse through social media, and this kid really wants to talk to you before they pass away. You kept prolonging this entire situation when you had many, many chances and could have easily talked to this kid. And later on, SS Sniper Wolf would actually then go on and talk to the kid, which is very good, because again, it was this 10-year-old's wish to talk to Sniper Wolf. But you could have done this a very long time ago, and judging by your past, this ghosting situation does not make you look any better. So I think we've all came to the realization how Essa Sniperwolf really is. Like we pretty much went over in this video, she has slandered, shit-talked other girls, started up drama for no reason, and basically cheated on her boyfriend, and just started a whole bunch of unnecessary shit, accusing a porn star for using your name for views when they didn't, and saying how dumb their job is. When you're literally the girl that makes the most dog shit reaction videos I've ever seen, with the most forced reactions out there. Essa Sniperwolf is a fake, lying piece of shit that tricks a young audience into thinking that she's this great, humble, respectful role model, who preaches about never making fun of others with low self-esteem, and she's been doing this since the Call of Duty days, and it's quite clear that Essa Sniperwolf has pretty much not changed at all. But that's pretty much all for today's video. If you guys did enjoy this content nuke video, then consider subscribing and drop a like if you want to. Go follow my Twitter at JamesLumpkinYT, that's the best way to know ahead of time before I upload my videos, and go follow my Twitch while I start streaming over there while chatting with you guys. So thanks for watching, I'll see you guys in my next video. Everybody's home.